We are Butterfingers. I'm Jenna.
I'm Heather.
I'm Vicky.
I'm Mike.
I'm Gail.
Raphael.
And our product is Coca-Cola Goes Green. So for what we want to do, we want Coca-Cola to go green and open Coca-Cola with happiness. Our plan is to have Coca-Cola bottles hanging from trees, representing renewal and recycling as the new Coca-Cola lifestyle. So this is a very family-friendly product that brings joy to the people around it. Go green and recycle. This product is not only for summertime, but also go green and become renewed in many ways, such as becoming a bird feeder and basis for soil and plants. For our commercial, we are going to start with soil and plant a Coke bottle in the soil for it to grow into a tree, going green. And then we are going to pick the Coke bottle from the tree. And then we're going to use the bottle as a base or a bird feeder, just as this one.
So for our target age, our age was between 16 and 40. It's like a middle age, so they know enough about like environmental issues and are also at an age where they drink soda. Our ad is not gender specific. It has a very neutral like color scheme and a neutral topic, so it appeals to any gender. The economic standing will be like middle to upper class, so they have the resources to do it. And the product in the ad appeal to all kinds of races and ethnicities.
So how we're going to try to get this to the people would be broadcasting on national TV during prime time, and this costs about $110,000 to put it in that time slot. And also, the internet is very popular nowadays, so we figured putting it on YouTube would be a very good way to get it to the people. And that costs about 10 cents per view, so if you have like if I have it on a video with like 100,000 views, that'll cost like $10,000, or like a million views, it's like $100,000. The place where we're filming the commercial is just like a public park, so it's free, but you gotta get a film permission form and just turn it into the park manager. You gotta hire a film crew, and that's about $20 per hour for each member. And then pay for the equipment too. It's like $500 for a camera, the lights are like $30, and then like the microphones, wireless microphones can be up to $500, depending on how many of these that could go from like a couple thousand dollars.
Different types of media really used to promote the original Coca-Cola product are YouTube, also Twitter, not only through tweets and promotions, but like voting and things like that. It's basically free, just ran through the normal website. And also newspaper to kind of appeal to more of those like married, at-home couples, the moms and dads that kind of sit and have coffee before they start out their day. Some of our objectives as a team is kind of to raise awareness for recycling and eco-friendly products. Also inform and educate people about the problems in the world and knock out the competition at the end of the day with like a new brand. Oh, back one more thing. Oh yeah, no, my bad. I just did. Marketing incentives are like recycling, like I said, that brings along a new group of people. Usually like people like vegetarians and vegans are really big on saving the environment. So, and like soda drinkers are usually those people that are eating pizza, chicken wings, things like that. So it kind of brings a new basis of consumers. Also, I have at the bottom, like it's kind of like you changing and taking your own way with this product, because at the end of the day, you have your like Coke bottle and you can like create it into anything. There's a wide variety. We'll have options later.
So our main purpose is that right now Coca-Cola Life is only available in Argentina, and we wanted to really make it more widespread and available in more countries so that more people are aware of the problem. So the materials that it's going to be made out of is bottles are made from 30% plant-based plastic, and they're all entirely recyclable. And another thing that we wanted to do with this product was change the design, because everyone knows Coca-Cola is like the red label. and making it green could have like a big impact on people noticing it. And then lastly, global warming. A big message that Coke wants to send is that global warming really is a problem, and one of their quotes from their website was, business can play a powerful role to help drive climate solutions through innovation and competition. And so the more big companies that start playing a part in fixing this problem, other companies will want to like level up and start working on it as well.
So for our commercial, we kind of chose things selectively. We chose to hang them from the trees to show that they're coming from natural environments, and kind of what Mickey was saying, how they're made from all natural, the bottles are made from all natural resources, kind of things like that. We kind of hope to show the various uses that the Coca-Cola bottle can have once you've finished it. We really wanted to kind of make it interesting and things that you can use around the house or outside, things like that. Like the luminarias, you can refill them to water plants, you can fill them with flowers. We chose Coca-Cola because it's a universal product. Everyone, no matter your age, gender, race, what language you speak, everyone around the world drinks it, so it's a universal thing that everyone can enjoy. Also, eco-friendly products sell more and they can apply to a wide variety of consumers and people across the nation and all around the world.
And our slogan was, what will you do with your Coke? Mm-hmm. You're all set. So that's our presentation.